Welcome back to the channel. Today we start with unboxing the Panda Jet. This omnidirectional cooling fan duct should enhance bridging and overhang quality. It comes with an Allen wrench and a sticker. As you can see, the lower magnets are already installed. Moving on to the Panda Extruder, an ultra lightweight extruder housing from aluminium with a really nice blue anodized finish. Besides the beautiful appearance, it's lighter than the stock one, and it comes with two bearings and an Allen wrench. Moving on to the last part, the Panda Claw, a nano-coated hardened steel gear, which also looks really nice. It comes with grease and two bearings. This part is a bit heavier than the stock one. This is a bit cheaper than the Bambu Lab one, but this definitely has my favorite. Before we can install the parts, we have to disassemble the printhead, and we start by removing the front cover and disconnecting the cables. When the cables are disconnected, we can remove the two screws that hold the hard end. This is also a great opportunity to replace your hard end by a hardened steel one. Now we remove the hard end, it's time to loosen the screw of the automatic cutter. When you loosen it enough, it should come out by itself. Now the cutter blade is out, we can remove the screws that hold the extruder. And don't forget to take the PTFE tube out. And this is where I realize I forgot one screw. And when that last screw is removed, we can remove the extruder after we disconnect the cable. All parts are out of the printer, and now we can replace the parts. From the front cover, we are going to reuse the fan. Now we're going to use our modified front cover and attach the Panda Jet to it. You can find models of the front cover on Maker World, and you can just snap this on. Something I forgot is that you need the two screws of the old front cover to attach this.
Thank you.
And after attaching the Panda Jet, we're going to place back the fan. Because I received the Panda Jet and I wanted to customize my front cover, this is the way I went. If you want a Panda Jet and you don't want to customize your front cover, I suggest you go for the Panda Jet pack, because it's fully printed in nylon, it is a nice aesthetic, and you don't have to print your front cover and put your own magnets in. So after we put in the magnets and the fan, the front cover is ready. Let's move on to the next part. First we have to disassemble the old extruder. Now we removed all the screws, we can remove the lid. If you're only doing the Panda Claw, you can just remove the old gear and insert the new gear. Now I'm peeling off the adhesive they put on the filament runout sensor cable. We already removed the screws, so we can just pull it out. Now we are removing the tension screw, and after this we can pull out the rest of the parts. Be sure you keep the spring and the end cap, we need that later on. After opening the new extruder, we're gonna put in the new bearing. You cannot see it well because my fingers are in the way, but I put in the spring with the end cap so we can put the tension screw in. Don't put it in all the way yet, because then the tension will be too much and you can't get the other parts in. The manual says that we have to put some lubricant on it, so yeah, let's do that. I'm using a saute pricker for this. And just make sure you don't put grease on the place where the filament goes. When everything is in place, we can secure the tension screw. And after we receive the message, it's time to close the extruder. After it's closed, we need to put back the filament runout sensor. Put in a smaller bit and put back the screws. And that's it. Now let's put it back. This is the same as before, only in reversed order. We're going to place the extruder, connect the cable, and put the screws in. It is easier when you put your print head much more forward, but in that case I would be blocking the view and I could not record this for you guys. Now we're going to put back the automatic cutter, and before I do that I take the screw a little further out so we don't bump into anything. When it's in place you can tighten the screw, but don't tighten it too much. That's what I did, and then it sticks. So loosen it up a little bit and make sure you can move it freely. Last part, reinstalling the hot end. And like I mentioned before, if you want to change your hot end, this is the time where you replace it by another. Tighten the screws one by one, and after you did that, just give them one more twist. This is the part I hate the most, is reconnecting the cables. There are some prints on MakerWorld to make this easier, but I still do it this way and I think it's still fitting. When the cables are in place, we're going to reconnect the fan and put on the front cover. And now basically we're done, and it's time to give my honest opinion. The Panda Claw is a definite yes. If you want to go for a hardened gear, Panda Claw is the way to go. The Panda Extruder looks great, is a little bit lighter than the original one, but I think this is optional. And finally, I would skip the Panda Jet and go for the Panda Jet Pack to show the aesthetics of the extruder. This concludes the video. Please like and subscribe. Thanks to BIQU for sending me the parts, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next.